Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed today one of the important type of hybridization, that is sp3. In the today's class, we discuss the unique property of carbon. So what do you mean by the unique property of carbon in the concept of hybridization? That is, the carbon in different molecules may undergo sometimes sp3, sometimes sp2, sometimes sp hybridization. That means it is undergo sp3 or sp2 or sp hybridization under different conditions. So that is our today topic. In which case it is undergo sp3, in which case sp2, in which case sp hybridization, that is we have to discuss with certain examples. The first one, that is sp3 hybridization. In the last class, we discussed with one example, in that the central atom is carbon, that is methane molecule. Same like that, but here I will take the one more important example, that is ethane molecule. Which molecule? Ethane. So the molecular formula of ethane is CH3CH3, that is C2H6. The two carbon atoms are there. Here the two are the central atoms. Okay. So in each case, the carbon is surrounded by three hydrogen atoms, and these two carbon atoms are connected through one bond. So we know very well the ground state electronic configuration of carbon, that is Z is equal to 6, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. In the valence shell electronic configuration, in 2s orbital, electrons are paired. In 2p subshell, in only two orbitals containing one electron, one will be remained as a vacant. This ground state electronic configuration could not account for the tetravalency of carbon. So that we need to be promote an electron from 2s orbital to 2p orbital. As a result, we get first excited state electronic configuration carbon, Z is equal to 6, first excited state electronic configuration, that is 2s1 2p3. In the 2s orbital, one electron is present. In 2p subshell, each orbital is filled with one electron. Now this first excited state electronic configuration of carbon can account for the tetravalency of carbon. Now here, one 2s orbital and three 2p orbitals hybridized together to form four sp3 hybrid orbitals. That means, in ethane molecule, around each carbon atom, how many sp3 hybrid orbitals are present? 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals are present. So how they are adapted, how they are oriented in the space? They are oriented in tetrahedral geometry. Around each carbon atom, so these 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals are oriented in tetrahedral geometry. So that is aldrin. Now, here one of the carbon atom hybrid orbitals. This is each sp3 hybrid orbital.
of one carbon atom, say for example this is C1 and this is C2, this is a one C1, and here also this is also will be oriented in tetrahedral geometry. So these are the four sp3 hybrid orbitals. This is the first carbon atom, this is the second carbon atom. So now here, first both the carbon atoms are linked together one sigma bond. So that's why the sp3 hybrid orbital of one carbon atom axially overlap with the sp3 hybrid orbital of another carbon atom. That means these two sp3 hybrid orbitals or overlap. These two are overlap and to form the sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by overlapping of sp3 and sp3 hybrid orbital of each carbon atom. Now around each carbon atom, how many sp3 hybrid orbitals are there? 4. Out of the 4, one is already involved at each carbon atom. How many left? 3 are left. These 3 sp3 hybrid orbitals at each carbon atom are overlapped with 1s orbital of hydrogen atom. That is 1s1. So only one unpaired electron is there. So now each sp3 hybrid orbital is overlapped with the 1s orbital of hydrogen atom at both the carbon atoms, axially overlapping every way. So that will be resulted into the sigma bond. Here also sigma bond is formed, sigma bond and sigma bond. So now here this is 1s orbital, this is sp3 hybrid orbital, 1s and sp3, 1s and sp3 hybrid orbital. Similarly, here also sp3 and 1s. Here also sp3, 1s, sp3, 1s. Like that, the sigma bonds are formed. Totally how many sigma bonds are there? The 7 sigma bonds are there. Out of the 7 sigma bonds, 6 sigma bonds are formed by overlapping of sp3 hybrid orbitals and 1s orbital of hydrogen atom. 1 sigma bond is formed by overlapping of sp3 hybrid orbital of each carbon atom, sp3 and sp3. So like that the 7 sigma bonds are formed. So the bond angle everywhere, whenever you see this, the bond angle is 109.5 degrees is observed. Bond angle is 109.5 degrees. So this is the one of the important example for the carbon is undergo sp3 hybridization. Once again I will explain, because it is some different example. Here two centers are there. So the in ethane molecule both the carbon atoms are undergo sp3 hybridization. So first we write the electronic configuration. The ground state electronic configuration could not explain the tetravalency of carbon. So that we need to be promote one electron from the 2s to 2p. That will be resulted into first excited state electronic configuration. In that, so the 4 orbitals are off field.
So this can be account for the tetravalency of carbon, so that 1 2s orbital, 3 2p orbitals are hybridized together to form 4sp3 hybrid orbital. This is a phenomena is occurs at both the carbon atoms. That means around each carbon atom, 4sp3 hybrid orbitals are present. Okay, fine. These 4sp3 hybrid orbitals around each carbon atom adopt the tetrahedral geometry. Here also tetrahedral geometry is there. So now, in the formation of ethane molecule, the two carbon atoms are linked together by one single covalent bond. So that out of the 4sp3 hybrid orbital, one sp3 hybrid orbital of both the carbon atoms are overlapped axially, so to form sigma bond. And at each carbon atom now 3 sp3 hybrid orbitals are left. So these 3 sp3 hybrid orbitals at each carbon atom axially overlapped with 1s orbital of hydrogen atom to form the 6 CH sigma bonds. So one is, so this sigma bond is between carbon and hydrogen. This sigma bond is between carbon and carbon. So like that, totally the 7 sigma bonds are present. Out of the 7 sigma bonds, 6 sigma bonds are formed by axially overlap of sp3 hybrid orbital of carbon atoms and 1s orbital of hydrogen atoms. And 1 sigma bond is formed by the sp3 hybrid orbitals at each carbon atom undergo axial overlap to form sigma bond. The bond angle is found to be 109.5 degrees. So this will be, we are written in simple term. So the carbon atoms are surrendered, okay, attached to the 3 hydrogen atoms. Here carbon is attached to 3 hydrogen atoms. So now, when you see that any 4 bonds around the carbon atom, so either here, or they are arranged in tetrahedral manner so that the bond angle is 109.5 degrees. Any, either HCH or HCC bond angle is 109.5 degrees. But whereas the bond length between the two carbon atoms is 154 picometers and the carbon hydrogen bond length is 109 picometers in the sp3 hybridization. This is, we need to be remembered. Sometimes it may be useful to explain the certain factors. What is the carbon-carbon bond length? Okay, in ethane molecule, whenever it is undergo the sp3 hybridization, that is 154 picometers. This is about the sp3 hybridization, okay, with the example of ethane. So in some cases, the carbon atom is undergo sp2 hybridization. The best example is ethene or ethylene. The molecular formula is CH2 double bond CH2, that is C2H4. So here also, in both the cases, the central atom is carbon. Here, the carbon is surrounded by 2 hydrogen atoms and 2, that is 1 double bond. So 2 hydrogen atoms are forming the 2 sigma bonds. And whenever a multiple bond, like double bond is present, in that one sigma bond, 1 pi bond. So that means this carbon atom is surrounded by 3 sigma bonds, 1 pi bond. So now here, the central atom carbon, Z is equal to 6. The electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So the valency of carbon is 4. The ground state electronic configuration could not account for tetravalency of carbon. So to explain that, we need to be promote one electron from the 2s orbital to 2p orbital. So that we get first excited state electronic configuration 2s1, 2p3. So now here 4 off-field orbitals are present. So here we are explaining only the formation of sigma bond with the concept of hybridization. How many sigma bonds are present around the carbon? The 3 sigma bonds. 2 are with hydrogen, 1 is with carbon. And what is the 4th one? 4th one is the pi bond. So to formation of the 3 sigma bonds, 3 hybrid orbitals are needed. For the formation of 3 hybrid orbitals, only the 3 atomic orbitals are hybridized. That's why out of the four atomic orbitals in the first excited state electronic configuration, only the three atomic orbitals are involved in the hybridization. One atomic orbital is not involved in the hybridization. Whichever it is not involved in the hybridization, that is called unhybridized orbital. This is called unhybridized orbital. So here, one 2s orbital, and out of the three 2p orbitals, only the two 2p orbitals are involved in the hybridization. So to form 2 plus 1, 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals. That means in ethylene molecule, around the each carbon atom, the three sp2 hybrid orbitals are present, one unhybridized orbitals are present. So whenever the central atom is undergo sp2 hybridization, so they are oriented in which geometry? Trigonal planar geometry. We are discussing in the last class, that is boron trichloride, BCl3. The central atom boron is undergo sp2 hybridization. All the three hybrid orbitals are oriented in trigonal planar. So here also, the three sp2 hybrid orbitals are directed towards the equilateral triangle, the corners of the equilateral triangle. That is a trigonal planar geometry. And at that carbon atom, one unhybridized orbital is also will be present. So how it is present, just I'll show here. So now, the three hybrid orbitals, are oriented in trigonal planar geometry. So these three are sp2 hybrid orbital. This is sp2. It is sp2 hybrid orbital. It is sp2 hybrid orbital. Making an angle between any two hybrid orbitals is 120 degrees. At this one carbon atom. At one carbon atom, one more is there. What is there? Unhybridized orbital. So that unhybridized orbital is perpendicular to this one. This is unhybridized orbital is present. So like that, at each carbon atom, three sp2 hybrid orbitals are oriented in trigonal planar geometry. The unhybridized orbital is oriented in whatever we write here, 2pz we write. So that is oriented along the z axis. So now let us come to, at each carbon atom, like it is present. Now I write here, three sp2 hybrid orbitals. I'll draw once again clearly. These three are the sp2 hybrid orbitals at this carbon atom. So three sp2 hybrid orbitals, one unhybridized orbital. This is unhybridized orbital at each carbon atom is present. Right. Now they are. So first we need to be linked between carbon and carbon and carbon and hydrogen. So out of the three sp2 hybrid orbitals, the two sp2 hybrid orbitals at each carbon atom overlapped with 1s orbital of hydrogen atom. Here also 1s orbital, here also 1s orbital. So of hydrogen atom,
which will be resulted into the sigma bond axially overlapping 1s orbital, here sp2 hybrid orbital, sp2 1s overlap, sigma bond sp2 and 1s, sigma bond sp2 1s sigma bond here. So then out of the three sp2 hybrid orbitals at each carbon atom, the two sp2 hybrid orbitals are axially overlapped with 1s orbital of hydrogen atom to form sigma bonds. Okay, fine. Out of the three, eight were involved, how many left? One is left. At each carbon atom, one sp2 hybrid orbitals are left. These two sp2 hybrid orbitals overlapped axially, so to form sigma bond. These two are overlap at each carbon atom. The two sp2 hybrid orbitals overlap. This will be resulted into the which bond? Sigma bond. Okay, fine. But in between carbon and carbon, not only one sigma bond, pi bond is also present. You know very well, the pi bond is formed by sidewise overlapping. Sidewise overlapping is always resulted into the formation of pi bond. So here pi bond is formed. This is pi electron cloud and pi electron cloud. So the two electron clouds are present. One is above the plane and another one is below the plane. So here simply write carbon, and carbon is connected to the sigma bond, and these two are connected to the hydrogen atoms, and these two are also will be connected to the hydrogen atom. Both are sigma bonds, and one is pi bond. That pi bond is formed by presence of electron cloud. Above the plane and below the plane. This is a pi electron cloud. Pi electron cloud is present above the plane and below the plane. That means all the six atoms, four hydrogen atoms, two carbon atoms are on the plane. So one is pi electron cloud is above the plane because of this sidewise overlapping. Another one is below the plane because of this sidewise overlapping. So like this, the formation of ethene molecules takes place. So here one more important point is the bond length is decreases. The carbon-carbon bond length is between carbon-carbon 134 picometers bond length. But whereas in the previous case 154 picometers we are observed, but here 134. Why the bond length is decreases? Simply, in the previous case, between the carbon and carbon, sigma bond is present, that is axial overlapping. But whereas in the case of ethylene molecule, the in addition to the sigma bond, pi bond is there, that is sidewise overlapping is takes place. That's why the atoms come very close to each other. When they are come close to each other, the distance between the two atoms is decreases because of the sidewise overlapping. That's why the bond length between the two carbon atoms is decreases from 154 picometers to 134 picometers when we are comparing ethane to ethylene molecule. So here one important point we need to be remember. So far we never anywhere discussed the formation of pi bond in while discussing the different types of hybridization. This is the first example is coming. So in the ethyl molecule, both are the carbon atoms are the center atoms. These two are attached to the hydrogen atoms. And both the carbons are connected through the two covalent bonds, one is sigma bond and one pi bond. Same like in the previous case, first we write the ground state electronic configuration. It does not account for the tetravalency, so that the promotion concept is needed. We are promoting the electron from the 2s orbital to 2p orbital. As a result, we are getting the four unpaired electrons in four atomic orbitals. But here around the carbon atom, only the three sigma bonds are present, one is pi bond is there.
To explain the three formation of the three sigma bonds, the three hybrid orbitals are needed. So for the formation of the three hybrid orbitals, only three atomic orbitals should be undergo hybridization. That's why out of the four sp3, out of the four atomic orbitals, only one 2s orbital, the two 2p orbitals are hybridized together to form three sp2 hybrid orbital. So one of the atomic orbital is not involved in the hybridization, that is called unhybridized orbital, which is help us to explain the formation of pi bond. Now, so at each carbon atom, the three sp2 hybrid orbitals are oriented in which geometry? The trigonal planar geometry. Trigonal planar. So whereas the unhybridized orbital is oriented in a z axis, which is perpendicular to the trigonal planar. So now at each carbon atom, the arrangement is like that. So now at each carbon atom, I am arranging the three sp2 hybrid orbitals, one unhybridized orbital. In the formation of ethene molecule, so out of the three sp2 hybrid orbitals at each carbon atom, the two sp2 hybrid orbitals at each carbon atom overlapped with 1s of orbital of hydrogen atom to form the two sigma bonds. Now, the third sigma bond is between carbon and carbon. So, that way at each carbon atom, one sp2 hybrid orbital is left. So, the each sp2 hybrid orbital at both the carbon atoms overlap axially. That is also resulted into formation of sigma bond. That means at each carbon atom, the three sigma bonds are clearly explained. But whereas these unhybridized orbitals are present at both the carbon atoms, they undergo sidewise overlapping to form the pi electron cloud above the plane and below the plane. That is resulted into the formation of pi bond between the two carbon atoms. So like that, so both the carbon atoms are connected by the one sigma bond and one pi bond, and both the carbon atoms are attached to the two hydrogen atoms at each center. And when we are observing the bond length, we are 134 picometer. But whereas in the previous case, 154 picometer. So the bond length is decreases because of the sidewise overlapping. Whenever the sidewise overlapping takes place, so the bond distance is decreases between the two atoms. That's why the bond length is decreases from 154 picometers to 134 picometer. So this is an best example. About the carbon undergo sp2 hybridization, that is ethylene molecule.